Hello everyone, welcome to this video on transport layer services. And in this video, we are going to talk about connection establishment. Now, as mentioned in our previous video, one of the services that is provided by the transport layer is connection-oriented services and connection-less services. Now, in relation to connection-less services, this particular lecture does not have any meaning, because there no connection is established. However, for connection-oriented services that is provided by the transport layer, three very important steps are to be followed. First is connection establishment. In order to establish the endpoints of communication prior to transfer. Second, next, once connection has been established, you can have the transfer of data. And at the end of all these data transfer, the connection has to be relieved so that none of the parties are left hanging at the end. So you can think of it as similar to making a telephone call. So when you make a telephone call, you usually say hello in the beginning. Okay, so that is like to ensure that the other party also knows that, okay, now you're going to say something. So it's kind of a saying, when you say hello, you are initiating the conversation over the telephone call. And when the other person also says hello, then it is like the other person also is willing to talk. So connection establishment is very important in case of a transport layer transmission of data. So it ensures that both the parties, that is the sender as well as the receiver, are ready to send and receive data. So in the normal situation, a two-way handshaking takes place. Like say, for example, I have a sender and I have a receiver. Okay, and this direction along this way shows the time. So I can say that this is time, say one, then this will be time, say n. Okay, so it is increasing. So 1, 2, 3, 4 up to n. So in this manner. Now, so here, first in a two-way handshaking, this is how it works. So here, the sender sends a connection request. Sends a connection request. So let me call it connection request to the receiver. So, and you can see this arrow moves from sender to receiver, and it is not in a same straight line because it is, I have not drawn it like this. Okay, because it is not going to reach immediately. Okay, it is going to reach at a later time. So I have not drawn this line in the same thing. So it is sending at time t1 and it is receiving it here. It is receiving it here. So this is the connection request. Now when the receiver receives the connection request, it also sends another message to the sender, which is the connection acknowledgement. So connection acknowledgement. So CR and CA. So when the sender receiver receives the connection request, okay, it sends the connection acknowledgement. And when the sender receives the connection acknowledgement, then it knows that the receiver is ready to receive. So after that, it can start with its data transfer. Now, it looks very simple, but it is not as simple as that. Because as mentioned in our previous lecture, below the transport layer is the network layer. And the network layer is unreliable. So packets that you send can get lost. Okay, you can have lost packets. Packets can be lost. Why? Because it is passing through the router. The router is being used by different connections. Each router will have some kind of a... So this is a router which is receiving data from multiple sources, let's say. And so when it is receiving, it cannot process everything as it reaches. So it has some buffers. It has some buffers. So this buffers So as the packets are arriving, it is storing it in the buffer. Now, sometimes if in high congestion situations, when there is a lot of traffic at this router, there may not be sufficient space available in the buffer. So the buffer could be full. So in that case, a new packet which comes in, there is no space, so it will be dropped. So we say that the packet is dropped. So essentially what happens, the packet gets lost. So packets can get lost. Packets can get corrupted. Okay, packets can get corrupted. Means you're sending a packet, then because of some issues in the physical media, the bits that you are sending, because let's say there is a high voltage fluctuation, and then maybe say the bits one becomes zero and zero becomes one. Suppose there is a something like this happens. So what happens? The data is, if even a single one becomes a zero or zero become a one, the packet will become meaningless. So the packets may get corrupted also. So you can have corrupt packets. Corrupt packets which are corrupted. Then you may have situations like delay. Okay, let me just clear this up so that I can just draw it here. So, So I may have, say this is the sender, this is the receiver. It is passing through multiple routers, okay? So there are multiple connections connecting the sender to the receiver, okay? Okay? So now when the packets are being sent from the sender to the receiver, they may choose to follow any path, okay? One may follow this path, okay? Another one may follow, say, this path. Another one may again follow some other path. Let's say this one, then again this one, okay? It can follow any path in this manner. So they may reach the destination or the receiver at different times. And because of this, there can be delays. You can have delays. The packets can be delayed. Also, delayed packets. So these packets could be delayed because, say, the packet has chosen a particular path, and then let's say there is a lot of traffic here, a lot of congestion here, and a lot of congestion here. So in such a situation, what happens? The packets will get delayed. So delayed packets also can cause problems, as we shall see. And on top of all of these, there can be some other issue. One very important issue which can happen. And what is that? That is the issue of delayed duplicates. Delayed duplicates. So I have, let's say, again, I have the sender and the receiver here. The sender has sent a connection request. Okay. Now, let's say, okay, let me draw it in a different way. Just let me draw it like this. Okay. I'm trying to show delay, so it will take more time. So let's say the connection request reaches here. Now, because the transport layer tries to provide reliable transmission over the unreliable network layer, so the transport layer is basically telling the user that don't worry, I'm going to make sure that your packet that you have sent is going to reach the destination. So to bring about this reliability, what the transport layer does is that it waits for an acknowledgement, okay, for a particular amount of time. And if the acknowledgement is not reached within that particular amount of time, then it performs retransmission. Retransmission of packets is done. So So the packet is transmitted once again. So now here, let's say this sender will wait for this amount of time, for time t. And in time t, the sender has not received an acknowledgement from the receiver for its connection, because it is only here that the sender receiver receives the connection request. So when it does not receive, and when the sender does not receive a acknowledgement up to this point, then what it does is that it sends a packet, the same packet, it sends it again. It performs retransmission of the packet. And again, why is this retransmission done? To bring about reliability. Okay, so now this packet is sent. A new packet connection request is sent. Now this connection request, okay, may take the fastest route, okay, and it may reach here. It may reach the connection, it may reach the destination at this point. Now, how will the receiver distinguish between the first packet, this packet, and this packet? Because both are requests for the same connection. So, the problem will be for the receiver to find out which connection request is valid. This, the first, the one it has received first, or the one it has received second. So, this type of packets are known as, which the second packet which you get here, this is known as a delayed duplicate. Okay? It could also happen not just because of the problem in the network layer. It could happen that the sender has crashed at this point. So, after it has come up, after the sender has come up again, then it sends a new connection request. Okay? So, this connection request and the earlier connection request that was sent, the receiver will have to distinguish between the two as to which one is the valid one. So, that is again another problem. Okay? So, handling of these delayed duplicates can lead to a number of issues. So, these are the issues that are there in two-way handshaking. Lost packets are lost. Delayed packets take more time to reach. Okay, corrupted packets which are discarded. Okay, now if you see, for lost packets and corrupted packets, this can be handled through retransmission. Okay, but for delayed packets okay, the problem happens with these delayed duplicate packets. So these are some of the issues. Now the issue is not just only for packets which are dead. Okay, you may also have a problem like this, where you have a delayed acknowledgement. Okay, so again, I have a sender and a receiver. Okay, so okay, this has sent the connection request. It has received this, and then this sends an acknowledgement, and it has reached here, connection acknowledgement. All right. Now let's say the sender crashes out here. So the sender crashes. Okay, so now at this point, let's say the sender comes up again. So it finds that it has crashed, so it is going to send the connection request again. So it sends the connection request again. Okay, but now what it has received? At this point, it has received an acknowledgement. But what the receiver has sent? The receiver has sent the acknowledgement for the first connection. So how will the sender now distinguish between whether this acknowledgement is for the first connection request or for the second connection request? So that is also a challenge. So not just the connection request packet can be delayed. You can have your delayed duplicates for connection request. And you may also have delayed duplicates in case of connection acknowledgement. So both of these can create a lot of problem. So, for handling delayed duplicates, okay, you have to undergo some kind of overhead. Some kind of additional work will have to be taken in delayed duplicates. And now, what do you want? You want the protocol to be correct. You don't want the sender or the receiver to be confused between a original packet and a duplicate packet. At the same time, you don't want to do so much of extra work to handle this delayed duplicate that it takes ages for the protocol to run. Okay, it takes a lot of time for the protocol to run. Okay, so there is always has to be a cost benefit between protocol correctness versus protocol performance. So what we would like to have is a balance between protocol correctness and protocol performance. We'd like the protocol to be correct. Also, we would like the performance not to be very bad. Okay. So in the next video, we will discuss about how these delayed duplicates can be handled.